I have known the piggy bank in country style since my earliest childhood. It accompanied us on all our moves and was supposed to provide comfort with its contents in times of need. But unfortunately, it was usually only sparsely filled. Where is home, Mama? On the great road. Where is home, Papa? Maybe here on this road, but this road is so long, so endlessly long. I can see the end and I'm so scared. Maybe I'll find you, maybe I'll find my home on the great road.
In my group, for instance, in family, to collect family photos and preserve them in albums. From the professional angle, as a student of cultural heritage studies at a Central European University, I'm looking at this as a perfect source to study the values, traditions and heritage of Roma community. Talking about photos, all of them have their own value for me because they are depicting my childhood, people who are relevant for me, my family. One of them, there is a depiction of my two grandparents, grandfathers from both sides, mother and father. And I think it's kind of unique. I mean, who could know that someday my parents would marry and I would be born. Talking about another photo, there is a depiction of my grandparents' wedding. I never seen my grandmother's dress during the wedding. I was just imagining how it is, and yeah, now I can see, and it's kind of amazing for me. And talking about the object I'm dedicating this, it is a book from the project Through My Mind to Your Eyes, established by my team, Agency of Advocacy Roma Culture, and myself. It is a book about children's stories of Roma community when these members went through genocide. They survived and they told their unique children's stories. And one of them, there is a story about my grandfather. While he was alive, he was telling the story several times to me, and when he passed away, I wanted it to make it out loud, to be heard by others. And it is interesting because my family could be eliminated, but due to the help of one German soldier, we were saved.
My grandmother, Patricia Molina Irigaray, was born in 1924 in a farmhouse in Andalusia. At the age of 8 years old, she started working in the farmhouse for a large and wealthy family in exchange for food. My grandmother had to scrub, clean, and wash the clothes in the river. The children, some of whom were the same age as my grandmother, treated her with contempt. One day, one of the daughters hit her. My grandmother got so angry that she took off her apron, crumpled it up in her hands and went to her family's farmhouse not to return. Her parents understood and did not force her to go back to work there. Time later, in her apron pocket, she found the spoon from that farmhouse used to put the spices for cooking. She did not return it. She kept it always. After moving to other regions of Spain and living in several houses, when she was 85 years old. She told my mother where that spoon came from and gave it to her as a present. Now my mom uses it every day to pour the coffee inside the coffee machine. In my family, this simple spoon is understood as a symbol of rebellion against mistreatment, exploitation, and classism. My grandmother, when she was 8 years old, did not know how to name what was happening in that house, but she knew that it was not right and it was not fair. These values have also been passed down from generation to generation and are embodied in this simple metal spoon. A practical object with no economic value and not at all opulent to represent the character of a whole family.